Good day everybody. This video will be about how to analyze data from a liquid limit test. So what you need to do first, please watch my video, which is available on my channel. So this is the link. This video shows how to obtain data. And I will teach you how to analyze the results of this test. And I have here a table. And in this table, you will see that we have four different tests. That's what we did in the video. Ideally, we would like to have at least five tests or even more to get more reliable results, but well, I did only four tests, and for each test we counted number of blows. That was our first test, 32, second test was 24 blows, and then we took a soil for a water content test, and we already knew the mass of the tin, so we put soil in the tins. So this is the mass for the first one. So then we measured soil when it was moist, it was 29.51. Then we put it in the oven for 24 hours, and after that we measured the mass of the tin with the soil, and it went down to 23.1 because the soil was dry. And I already calculated moisture content. So this is what we actually need to get liquid limit. I will show you how we calculate moisture content, and then I will show you how to draw a graph and find liquid limit. So I'm just going to look at the first test because other four tests are the same. What we need to do is we need to remember the formula for water content, and water content is a mass of water divided by mass of solids. And to find mass of water, what we're going to do is we're going to find the difference between mass of wet soil and mass of dry soil in this case. And to find mass of solids, we're just going to find the difference between of mass of dry soil and mass of tin, that container that we use to measure soil. So now let's look at test one and see what we have. So mass of wet soil was 29.51. Mass of dry soil together with the tin, it was 23.1. So now we're going, so this is mass of water. So mass of solids is it's mass of dry soil with the tin, 23 minus 1, minus the mass of the tin just by itself, 7.7. And what I did, I changed it to a percentage, so multiply by 100%. So if you do the calculations by yourself, you will see that we're going to have water content, or what we call it also moisture content, 41.6%. And this is what I put here in the moisture content. So what you do, just practice by yourself for test 2, test 3 and test 4. So you're gonna use all the data here. So what we do next is we are going to we're going to plot all the data. Just remove this. And what I would like to do is I'm going to look at the number of blows. This is what we counted during the test. And we're going to plot it against moisture content. So I already did it here. This is number of blows comes from this column. And moisture content comes from this column. What you need to remember is for this axis, when we plot number of blows, we need to put it in log scale. Log scale. For moisture content, we don't need to change the axis. So what I would recommend, just maybe use Excel, plot your data in Excel, and then there is an option in Excel where you can change the axis from arithmetic to log scale. That will be the easiest. So now we have results from four tests. So these are four tests. And then we'll draw a line of best fits, which is shown here. And to find the liquid limit, we need to find the moisture content that correlates with 25 blows. So if we have this log scale, this is going to be 20, and this is going to be 25. So we're going to go up and see where it correlates. 2, 4. So liquid limit will be approximately 42.6%. So that will be the answer for this soil. Thanks, guys. Subscribe and put some likes. Bye.